Video chat apps are great at connecting friends and family across the globe, and especially in times like these where social distancing is becoming the new normal, they help give you a little bit of that social interaction back. So in this video, I'm going to go over two popular free video chat apps, Google Duo and Google Hangouts. I'm going to show you how to use them, go over their core features, and when you may want to use one over the other. Let's dive in. To get started with either Google Duo or Google Hangouts, you'll want to make sure that you have a Google account set up. To do that, just go to google.com, click sign in, and then follow the steps to set up your account. Now, if you're simply trying to have a conversation with 8 people or less, including yourself, and you don't need the ability to share your screen on desktop or to have a chat in the same window as your video chat, then I think Google Duo is going to be the way to go for you. Now, Google Duo is available on lots of different platforms. It's available on multiple different types of browsers like Chrome, Firefox, and Safari, and it's also available on different mobile platforms, including iOS and Android, and it's also available on some Google Assistant smart displays like the Nest Hub Max. To get started on a mobile device like Android or iOS, download the Duo app from the App Store or the Google Play Store. On a computer, you can use the web version of Duo through Chrome, Safari, and Firefox. And the best part is that you don't have to download an app or an extension to use it, at least not in Chrome, which is the browser that I use. Google Duo uses your Google contacts to allow you to call others. If you're using an iPhone, Duo will use the contacts you have on your phone. If you select a contact that doesn't currently have Duo downloaded, you'll see a screen where you can invite this contact to Duo through a text message. When you tap on a contact that does have Google Duo downloaded, you'll see a different screen with a few options: voice call, video call, and message. The message option allows you to record a video message and send it to your contact. You also have options to use filters and effects here as well. And you can also just leave a note or voice message in case you don't want to be on camera. The actual interface of Google Duo is very simple. You have buttons to end the call, mute your microphone, or your camera. And there are more options as well. On the phone app, you can click the 3 dots, and then you'll see you have options for auto framing, portrait, low light, and effects, where you can use fun effects that will overlay your current video. With Google Duo, if you want to have a call with multiple people, you can do this by setting up a group within the app. Now, do note that groups have a maximum capacity of 8 people, including yourself. To create a group in the app, you scroll the contacts page up a bit and then hit Create a Group. Then select all of the people that you want to be in the group, then hit Done. Give the group a name, and then click Start to start a video call or leave a video message for the group. If you've been added to a group that you don't want to be a part of, click the 3 dots and then you'll be able to leave the group. Duo also has a knock-knock feature, so when you receive a call, you actually see the video of the person calling you before you pick up the call. Oh, and another thing to keep in mind with Duo is that all Duo calls are end-to-end encrypted, so your conversation stays between you and the people you're calling. Another cool feature with Duo is the ability to call your Google Home devices. When you look through your contacts in Duo's mobile app, you'll see a button where you can call your Google Home devices like your Nest Hub, Nest Mini, or other smart speakers in your house. This is useful for when you're out of the house and you need to get a hold of someone back home, especially if your home is like mine where there's at least one Google Assistant in every room. When you click that button, every device in your residence will ring, so keep that in mind when you want to play a prank on someone and startle them in the middle of the night. Alright, so we've gone through all of the main features of Duo, and now I want to talk about Hangouts. Now, I know at this point you may be thinking, wait a minute, Duo does everything I need, why would I even need to think about Google Hangouts? And I know I thought the exact same thing when I was doing the research for this video, but after doing further research, I think there are some circumstances where you would want to use Hangouts over Duo. And the first one is if you want to have a video call with more than 8 people, including yourself. Hangouts currently has a limit of 25 people on a video call. And the second scenario where I think you would want to use Hangouts over Duo is if you want a chat service built in with the video and audio call service. Currently, Duo Duo does not have a chat service available with it. It is only videos and calls, where Hangouts actually has a pretty nifty chat service built right in. Hangouts allows you to chat with up to 150 people in a group, and it allows you to quickly jump into a video or voice call from your chats. You also have the ability to set a status and can invite people to Hangouts either through their email or their phone number. You can also make yourself visible on Hangouts to anyone with your phone number or email. Another big difference with Hangouts is that it lets you chat while your video session is going on. You have the ability to share your screen in Hangouts as well, which is especially useful for presenting to a group or helping troubleshoot an issue a family member is having with their computer. Like Duo, Hangouts is available on a wide variety of devices, including iOS and Android phones, tablets, and various computers through the browser. Note that Hangouts is not supported on Google Assistant displays, though. And from what I could find, the service is not end-to-end encrypted like Duo. When you start up Hangouts on mobile, you can use the plus button at the bottom right-hand corner to start a new conversation or a video call, and on desktop you have similar options as well. You can actually start a video call on desktop without calling anyone, and then invite them to join your call by email or through a link that you can share with them. Hangouts video call features are similar to Duo's. You have buttons to end the call, turn your mic on and off, as well as your camera. You can click the three dots, and that's how you can get to the area where you can share your screen on a desktop. One pointer for if you're on a Mac: to share your screen, make sure that you click on the screen that pops up and then click share. Do note though that Hangouts does not have the auto framing features, and it doesn't have any fun crazy filters like Google Duo does. Alright, well that's it for our video on Google Duo and Google Hangouts. If you found this video helpful and liked this video, hit that thumbs up button below and subscribe to the channel to see more videos like this one. Also, feel free to share this video with any friends or family who may need a little bit of help with video chatting. For 6 months later, I'm Josh Tedder. Thanks for watching.